So on this clip, I'm going to talk about how you can stimulate and exercise and at the same time train your dogs in your garden, front garden, and also when you take them for walks once a day. I know that it's very difficult this time when we cannot let dogs off the lead, or it's recommended not to let your dogs off the lead in the parks. So their routine has changed quite significantly. Now, on this clip, I'm going to talk about agility exercises. What are the benefits of practicing agility? Obviously, it's a physical exercise, and as you could see on the introduction clip, many dogs really love it. And now the second benefit is control. Agility requires very high level of control, as dogs have to pay attention to you while they are running fast and also managing the agility equipment. And the third, it's more variable, it's more interesting to mix the obedience training a little bit with some physical exercise, some agility. There is actually a dog sport discipline that does exactly the same. It's called rally obedience, which mixes the obedience exercises with agility and with some tricks. Even the basic level of agility that you will do in your garden requires quite a decent obedience level. So what are the exercises that you will need in your agility practice? First of all, sit weight. Now obviously this can be a lie down weight or stand weight. And sit or lie down that your dog will do on the agility table or in the garden agility on the agility mat. And then obviously your dog has to come to you, follow your left hand, right hand, turn as you move, pay attention all the time, and slow down, speed up according with your movement. I'm going to show now how to teach these basic obedience exercises. I'm going to use Moon. She is already 11. Because she's slower, it will be easier to show the exercises with her, and you will have a longer time to watch and see exactly what I am doing. So the first exercise will be the sit weight. Moon, close. 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 No, not close. Sit. Wait. So the first step is just wait for longer. Sit and wait for longer, and you can then reinforce. Yes. Yes. And as I give the reward, repeat the command. Sit, wait. Because then I start a new exercise. So whenever you reward your dog, if you want to start again, you have to tell your dog again. Wait. Yes. Now, while she's waiting, I can do as just walk next to her, pretend even running, because when you do the agility, you will walk, run. And yes, reward, wait. She likes this, just for sitting, getting a lot of food. Wait. And pretending that running, and then as you do it or walk, you can do inches away, come back, again, yes. And then gradually extend the distance. Wait, come back, yes. So at this stage I am not calling her, because then she would anticipate the call, especially if they already liked doing the agility, and then it's more difficult to teach her to wait patiently. So at this time I am coming back to her, yes. Now, the next step, when you start calling your dog, here. It's not a very fast here, but we'll do it. And again, can repeat from there. Sit. Moon, sit. Wait. Here. Yes. So at the moment as she comes, I remote her. And then the next step will be that she has to follow you. And she has to follow you practically your hand. So you will lead, so you will be the first. Your hand and then your dog. Sit, wait, sit. Sit, wait, here. So this time I can start moving with her. Turn, move with her. I can do the get her again. She has to walk around me. She can turn here, 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 moon here. Yes. Okay. So possibly she saw some rabbits. So at least you will not have that distraction in your garden. Moon off. Fui. Fui. Here. So the sit wait and then was the first exercise. The second exercise is the here. The third exercise is the following your hand or following you. And fourth exercise is the go to a target. Now this is also very important because I teach all the equipment with targets. If I'm showing my hand, and especially if I have food in my hand, moon, follow, jump. My dog looks at the hand and not at the really at the equipment, so can knock it down. So that is why it's important that the dog can focus at the equipment and teaching the equipment with target. So I just get some feeding station. So I use these caps as feeding stations. You can use some cup, table mats, jar caps, anything practically. And you can put it down. You can initially put some food on it that your dog can see it. And then you tell your dog leave. It's even faster if you put down two. Leave. Moon, here, go! Oh. She went to the, didn't see the cap, she went to the mat. Moon, here, here, go! So go, say go, point. And point with the near hand. So when your dog is at right hand side with the right hand, because if you cross the hand, then you turn towards the dog, so you cannot run in that direction. And again, leave, leave. So I'm practicing the leave exercise, go! Moon. Here it is. Go. Move. Leave. 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 Leave here. Leave. Leave here. Here. So this is also very important. Go. Very important exercise. Now, as you call your dog away with the here, remove the here. Leave. Leave. Here. Yes. And then go. Leave, leave, here, yes. She's just going to the other one. Okay, so this time I will just use one and call her away. So this is more visible, so I will show it with this one. Or I can put the two together. Leave, leave, here. So I call her away here. And moon, go. Yes. And once more, leave, here. Leave here. Now if your dog wouldn't leave it, you can practice this on the lead. Wait. Go. So these exercises require high level of control. Look forward to seeing you again.